Hello, and welcome to the online course for the Automate the Boring Stuff with Python book. I'm Al Swigert. I'm a software developer and tech book author. Automate the Boring Stuff with Python is my fourth programming book, and now I've made an online course that follows the book's content. Learn to code has become a huge mantra. You have sites like Code Academy and Khan Academy and massive online open courses to teach people to program. You hear things like coding is the new literacy or how everyone in the 21st century will have to learn to code. And if you want to become a software developer, this course can be your first few steps on that path. But what if you don't want to change careers to software engineering? You're still getting these learn to code recommendations from everyone, mostly from people with a book to sell. By the way, Automate the Boring Stuff with Python is released under a Creative Commons license, so you can buy a print or ebook, or you can read it online for free at automatetheboringstuff.com. Is there a reason the average office worker, student, or administrator should learn to code? Yes. Whether you have to send emails, visit websites, or go through a ton of spreadsheets and PDFs, these jobs use laptops and desktop PCs as their primary tool. And sometimes using a computer means spending hours doing tasks that require a bunch of mindless clicking and typing. If you don't have an intern to shuffle this work off to, you should learn to code so that you could program the computer to do these tasks for you. Or if you're the intern, you should learn to code so that you can program the computer to do these tasks for you. So, how is this course different from all the other online programming courses? Well, I wrote Automate the Boring Stuff with Python for people who wanted to get up to speed making small programs that do practical tasks as soon as possible. You don't need to know sorting algorithms or object-oriented programming paradigms, so this course skips all of the computer science and concentrates on writing code that gets stuff done. But if you are a computer science student or budding software engineer, this course will be a good first step to develop your toolkit of programming skills. This course uses the Python programming language. Python is the best first language to learn. Many universities are switching their computer science curriculum away from Java and to Python. It has a simple syntax and a gentle learning curve, but it's still a powerful language used in the real world. Google, NASA, Yahoo, YouTube, and even non-technology companies like JP Morgan Chase or Industrial Light and Magic all use Python. So learning to code can increase your productivity, but it's also a fun creative skill. And unlike other creative skills or hobbies, if you have a computer, there's nothing else to buy in order to write code. You don't have to buy paint or yarn or power tools. All you need is some free software called the Python Interpreter. Sound good? Let's get started, right now. Open a web browser and go to python.org. You'll need to download and install Python for your operating system. This is slightly different on Windows, Mac, and Linux, so consult the course notes for specific instructions. The one thing you need to know is that you should download a version 3 Python, like Python 3.5, and not a version 2 Python, like Python 2.7. When we say Python, we usually mean either the Python interpreter software that you've just downloaded and installed, or the Python language. Python, the software, comes with an editor program that you type your Python, the language, code into. The editor is called IDLE. Consult the course notes for how to start up IDLE on your operating system. Beginning in the next lesson, we'll start writing code using it. I highly recommend that you have IDLE open and follow along with the videos by typing the examples into it. Don't just sit and watch the videos. It's easy to passively watch the videos and think you understand the concepts. Typing the code builds your muscle memory and forces you to see if you can get the code working. One last thing that you should know from the start. Half of a software engineer's day is spent Googling for information. Programming can be complicated, and no one can keep all this information in their head. So don't feel bad about constantly looking stuff up on the internet. That's exactly what professional software developers do every day. So if you get an error message, and you have no idea what it's talking about, a good starting point is copying and pasting this message into a search engine. The first three results will probably be to a website called Stack Overflow, which is a great question and answer site. So before asking people for an answer, try to find the answer yourself on the web. One, this will almost always be faster because two, other people have probably had your question and already had it answered. But when you do ask questions, provide as much detail as possible. Here's a few things to keep in mind. Explain what you're trying to do, not just what you did. Your helper can then tell you if you're on the wrong track. If you get an error message, specify the point at which the error happens. What line number does it happen on? Does the error happen every time, or does it just happen randomly sometimes? Copy and paste the entire error message and your code to a pastebin site like pastebin.com or gist.github.com. These websites will give you a link to your text, which makes it easy to share with other people. Explain what you've already tried to do to solve your problem. This trims down the list of possible causes and tells people that you've already put some work into figuring things out on your own. List the version of Python you're using. Also, say if you're running Windows, Mac, or Linux, and what version you're running, like Windows 7 or Mavericks 10.9.2. Asking effective questions and knowing how to find answers are invaluable tools on your programming journey. Let's begin.